Listen to some of it.
I listened to one song.
Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name's Avia. If you're new, hello. If you're old, hello. And I have my little sister,
Leandra.
And today we'll be reacting to the DJ Khaled album that just dropped. What's it called?
Khaled.
Okay, so long time no see. Y'all probably haven't seen me in like 2 months. No, the reason being, she's been on me about this because I'm kind of like lazy or whatever, but I have college and transferring processes and getting through the semester. And today is my day to like relax because it's at the end and I'm almost done with all my classes. I just have a few more things to do. So I was like, why not? You know, I can do this. So let's get into it. I mean, this album is loaded from what I've seen. I mean, I've seen Megan, Cardi, Justin Timberlake, mm-hmm. P. Diddy. Who else? Justin Bieber. Who else is like a big art? Post Malone, DaBaby, Lil Baby.
Drake
on it?
Mm-hmm. I think he has 2 songs.
Yep. Is it Roddy Ricch on it too?
I think.
Basically, DJ Khaled just got all the top artists that we have right now, seem like. And just put them on this one album. Her.
So it better be good.
So let's get started. What's the first track? She's controlling the music and we have a speaker, so.
I'm just going by his album. So the first one is Thankful.
Thankful.
I'm just gonna put
who's on it?
I don't know. Lil Wayne?
Lil Wayne on it?
Lil Wayne.
All right, I think that was a solid opening track about, because I follow DJ Khaled on Instagram, mm-hmm. So he's kind of like all about God and, you know, being thankful for everything. God is light, you are light, we are light, like all that. So I felt like that song was like, it set the tone for, I guess, what he's trying to preach about. Be thankful, you know, the heavens.
Rate it 1 out of 10.
1 out of 10, I rate that song a good solid 6. Mm. It's a good opening track, I think. Unexpected with Lil Wayne and Jeremiah. I feel like they both did their thing, you know. Lil Wayne did his little, you know, he put in his little 2 cents. He always does wordplay. So I appreciated that.
I thought it was a tad bit boring. That's just me.
The intro
was very long. So I was like, okay, where are we going with this? But the lyrics were really, like, good. Like, if you listen to it, I think it had a good meaning.
What do you rate it out of 10?
Just a solid 5. Is but like they always put like the first songs. I noticed this in people's albums that they don't really care too much about. So,
all right. So the next song is
Every Chance I Get.
And who is it?
I don't know. I can't see it.
Oh, she can't see it.
Oh, it's Lil Baby and Lil
Durk.
Maybe. Did you say? Take
it. I think this is Lil Baby and Lil Durk.
At first I wasn't feeling it at all, but it was all right.
I give that track a solid 7. I feel like their verses were like even. Mm-hmm. not one did better than the other, so I guess they complimented each other with the voices and the style of rapping. Not my favorite song. It's not something I would just be like, yeah, put that Lil Durk and Lil Baby on. No, I wouldn't do that. But if it came on, like, in a car, I wouldn't tell somebody to change it. That's how I feel about it. So, yeah. What do you feel?
What was I going to say?
Were you about to give the rate?
Oh. I was going to say, I feel like it's one of those songs where, like, the first listen, I'm like, eh. But if I listen to it again, I'll probably like it more. It's like a grower, I feel like. But I give it a 6.5.
Yeah. All right. So the next song we're gonna do is
"Big Paper,"
Cardi
B. I have heard a lot about this song.
I have high hopes for this because it's Cardi B.
I don't, cause I've seen a lot of things on Twitter, a lot of things on TikTok.
She be in tune with that. I keep up with music, like when people drop albums, but I do not look at it. I do not listen to it. I do not feed into what the people say. Mm-hmm. Even though most of the time they probably write. So she knows that they've probably been down Like,
because a lot of people, like, they just don't like Cardi. They probably put the worst part of the song online and made it seem like the whole song is just trash like this. It's probably...
Now, yeah. I did see that she said she wrote her verse in 2 hours.
I think 2 hours. I thought it was 2 days.
2 days? Oh, I don't know. Two something, which is short.
24 hours. Who knows?
But, yeah, let's go. Big paper, Cardi B. We the
best music. I already like the beat.
Another one. DJ
Khaled. I get big paper, so I deal with big haters. Big paper, so I deal with big haters. Big paper, so I deal with big haters. I got it out the mud, they ain't do me no favors. Ain't no bitch like her, that's why these bitches don't like her. I respect shit, starters, not no shit typers. 3 year break, I still get this shit hyper. Shot back to the top, don't make a bitch snipe ya. Big body, they can fuck with me hardly. Body anybody saying they don't know my body. I sun bitches move culture out the car seat. Got these hoes nervous, I can spit it to their heartbeat. Super valid, anytime I lay Dallas. 5 number 1s, you got 5 number 9s. Dipping on cardio, that never shit done. Off with your head, all that cap and shit done. And I got Hollywood ready when this rap is shit done. I get big pay, big haters. I got it out the mud, they ain't do me no favors. The most imitated, innovated, instigated. Playlist favorite, yo shit never played it. Had to make a way and your shit never made it. I was broke in the Bronx, but a bitch never hated. Had to get my weight up, so I patiently waited. House with the palm trees for all the times I was shaded. Niggas at the Woolworths, no, we never dated. Stop lying on the pussy when you know you never ate it. Big diamonds, single big diamonds. You will never get a share. Ride nigga faces, I don't never get a chair. If I don't take a break off, you will never get a year. At the mud, they ain't do me no favors.
We the best music.
Another one.
Another one.
All right. I give that track an 8 out of 10.
It wasn't bad.
I don't know who was listening to this that said it was pure garbage, according to Twitter. I think Cardi did her thing.
Yeah.
Now, I do feel like the big paper, big whatever, it might have got annoying to somebody, but she is the only one on the track.
Yeah.
She's not with anybody else singing on the track. I felt like she brought the New York style to the song, obviously with how her flow went. I liked it. She had a lot of punchlines, obviously. I feel like she threw a couple shots at whoever, unless she just speaking, but there was definitely like punch, boom, like I'm Cardi B, like speaking on me, you just make me more famous, whether it's positive or negative. So just keep on doing what you're doing, yeah. And I'm gonna keep on doing what I'm doing.
Like some parts of the song, like you're not gonna like every single part of the song. Like that's just some songs, it's just like, I don't really like that. You know, could have did this, could have did that. But the whole point is, like, people took the worst part of the song, that is the worst part in my opinion, and turned it into, like, oh, she's chasing the beat, she wasn't on beat.
And that was, like, her hook. Song, like, her hook or chorus, if you'd rather. That was her hook. Big paper, yeah. So I get it with big
paper. It wasn't bad at all. I liked it.
And with her writing that in 2 days, she did her thing. She did what she could. I feel like she brought what she had to bring to the table. She brought Cardi to the table. I don't like when people expect somebody to fall into another rapper's style or what they presume should be the standard of rap. Mm-hmm. When I don't understand why people want the same thing anyway. Like I feel like different is good. So I feel like Cardi did what she came to do. So I like Cardi's song.
Yeah, it's Cardi B is an easy target for a lot of people lately. Like it's just Cardi B, Cardi B. Like Cardi's trash, Cardi's whack, blah blah blah. Stop worrying about Cardi B. If you don't like Cardi, then move on.
They do the same thing with Megan. They do this with female rappers. I don't know what the problem is.
Yeah, it's very annoying. Like I like the song. It wasn't that bad. I like the song. It wasn't bad at all. Matter of fact,
I liked it.
Good.
She had some punchlines, but I was like, okay,
yeah.
Okay, she definitely brought the Bronx to the song.
She wrote it herself. Not many people can do that. Until you can write a song, rap it, be on DJ Khaled's album, then you can speak.
Yeah, dark, yeah. So, I liked it. What do you rate it out of 10, or did you already say?
7.5.
Is that your highest score?
I think so.
See?
I like it. If I listen to it, like I liked it then. I don't really like songs like that on first listen. I liked it.
And the beat was good, so yeah. Alright, y'all. So now we're on song number 4. It is Going Crazy. I'm Going Crazy.
We
Going Crazy. Her featuring the Migos. Well, DJ Khaled featuring her featuring the Migos. So I think this is gonna be good. Her and the Migos, that's a I've never thought about that collaboration. So let's see. That's a sample. Best music. It's just slowed down a little bit.
She wanna taste it. I had to level up, I was too patient. Back to the hood, we going back to the base. They said I hate you, but smile on your face. Jump through that chin in my
I give that song a 9 out of 10. Her did her thing. Her carried. I don't care. Her carried. Migos did their thing.
I can't.
Don't get me wrong. Her did her thing. I like how they put that hip hop beat, which I think is a sample from a song, with a reggae beat. That went well. And they delivered on that. Yes. That's all I have to say. What do you have to say? The 8? She gives it an 8 out of 10. That's your high score. And my high score was this song. Dang, that was track number 4?
Going crazy.
Who's after that? Y'all, so we're now on track 5. And it is with
Post Malone, Megan the Stallion.
Lil Katie and the Katie. We're playing. I think y'all get what artists we're trying to say. If you don't, then you're living under a rock.
It's Post
Post Malone, Megan Thee Stallion. That's Thee Stallion, the H-Town Hottie at Lil Baby and the Baby. That's 4 people on the song. Oh, and DJ Khaled.
Somebody was not needed, and we're gonna find out who today on the Morning Show. And we'll see who was not needed.
And what's it called?
It's called I did it. Sorry, I listened to it.
Come on. Okay, this is my type of style. I like rock music now.
That's the best song.
This bitch is so quick to switch up. I'm from the low store, I don't need to kick up. It ain't directed, so it ain't respected. Stop dropping clues, cause I ain't no detective, bitch. I'm trying to win. Don't care how I do it, just know that I did it. Why you so worried about what I be doing? Counting my money ain't making you rich. Talking talking down on me don't make you shit. I'ma lay me in your mouth more than your spit. I really encourage my haters to talk, throwing your shade on me, keeping me lit.
Enthusiast becoming to be. I love rock music. Hits my shirt. Kiss. They mix that. I like how he's mixing genres with other genres.
Yeah.
And they're going so well. He mixed the previous song, he mixed hip hop with reggae. This song, he mixed rock with hip hop. And it works. He put the electric guitar with a hip hop beat. Post Malone did his thing. He did what he do. I think he's the chorus person. He made the chorus. Megan talked her stuff like she always did.
Everybody came.
I felt like she kind of came. I feel like her and Cardi had kind of the same message with their verses. They just delivered it differently. They delivered it with their styles. Megan is from Houston. Shout out to Texas because that's where we're from. And Cardi is from New York. She came with the Bronx style. What did Megan say? They keep my name more in their mouth than their spit.
No, that's what Megan said.
Yeah, Megan. She said, I was like, what the? She's cold. I don't care what anybody says. She always got the bars. We thought she got same
flow. Y'all wanna know my favorite rappers, female rappers? Rank number one is Megan. It's Megan.
Yeah.
People know I love Megan.
And people will agree with this. Will disagree with this, I mean. And some people will agree with this.
My second favorite right now, I'm talking about right now, is Mulatto. Mm-hmm. I like Mulatto.
And I think we're biased because we are from the South. We are from Texas. We live in Texas. So the style of their rap hits us more, I guess, if that makes sense. Rather than a New York style rapper. We lean more towards a Southern rapper because that's what we grew up listening to. Like old Southern rap, like UGK, Big Mo, all them type people. We know all those people. So yeah, Lil Baby came out the gate with his verse. He did better in this song, I think, than the one with Lil Durk. And DaBaby do what he always do. I feel like DaBaby, his lyrics aren't the best in my opinion, but his voice ups the ante for him. Like you already know who it is if he jumps on a track. Like you could hear from a mile away and be like, oh, that's DaBaby. Yeah. Like he just has like that voice. So they all did their thing. And they did a good track. Another one. That song's a 10 out of 10. Alright y'all, so the next song is number 6 on the album, called Let It Go with
Justin Bieber and
21 Karat Gold.
Is it 21 Savage from there? UK?
Yeah.
England or somewhere like
Great Britain. He's from the UK, but which country in the UK? Because there's England, Wales, Ireland, and Scotland, I think. But I'm assuming he's from England, so. Yeah. Let's get started.
You keep on pushing the bed back.
Sorry.
You like it?
We the best music.
Post Malone's like fake singer, like he goes in there and does all the singing, which is fake. That's not true. I don't know why I said that, but it sounded like if you lower the pitch, it sounds exactly like Post Malone. Yeah, I mean, exactly. if you higher Post Malone's pitch, it sounds exactly like Justin's pitch.
That threw me off.
Like it, they literally sound the same. I wish I could show you all the video.
Oh,
yeah, but I like that part.
I let it go. If you say that you love me, that shit better show. Oh God. Don't try to play like I'm slow, cause you been around the block and I know this
show. So funny.
She asked me sick, cause I give her some more, and I'm proud of myself, cause I used to be dope. Now I just hustle and grind, stack it to all of my muscles and soul.
Poor.
Don't play sport, but I bow. Answer the phone when I call. I kill it whenever I fall. Try me as gunning, pick up. $40 million every time I do a pickup. Fans got their arms in their other like a stick up. Money going like a guy.
Life is a bitch, but sometimes it's alright.
Another one.
Another solid song.
Written by 21 Savage, DJ Khaled, and Justin Bieber.
That was good. I give it a solid 7.5.
I'm gonna give it a 7.5 too.
Because 21 Savage made me laugh.
Yeah.
Freaking on that show. I was Poe. He didn't say poor, he said Poe. That's how you know it was.
I like the mud part of the song.
Ooh. Yeah. They both did their style, and the beat fit Justin a lot. I don't know if it fit 21 Savage, which I guess is why they kind of cut the beat and he came on, in a way. But, yeah.
Cut the buck as a beat.
Like, conceded.
It reminded me of Intentions.
Oh, the beat?
Some part of it reminded me of a certain... Nope. I don't know how to explain
it. What do you rate it?
I said what you said.
Oh, you did? Oh. We both give it a 7.5.